Right, back to hurry, hurry, save the world before I die. Because I pretty much am irrelevant here as a human being. I am merely a spokesperson for the events of brain power I gathered that we're able to deliver. Now, back to Tiananmen and those tanks. My goodness, because they're so massive, and we're thinking a business, global business, directly. What do we make from the tanks? I am immediately running to mag wheels and being funny like this, and making little tinsie fast cars, turning them, converting them to the mag wheel company as a collector item, because that would be something very substantial as a business. And yet, my mind wanders back to energy. We have to think of Bejing and the pollution. So, to cut down on the pollution, I'm in the design ordinance of taking the tanks, because they are so massive. They are a great use. We can use them. Tilt the tanks facing down, and so they're running on the belts, on the constant. They're running on the belts, on an underbelt. So you have an underbelt and an overbelt. And the underbelt is larger. And so it is in a constant running, just as a ball on a hill. So the tanks are running like a little tiny ball on a hill, but yet they stay in the one place. So that is where we're thinking that the tanks can be used. I don't believe you would use the turret gun pointing into the ground to hold it. I don't think that is necessary. I think when you take the gun off, really that it will be a faster. If you have the gun pointed into the ground, into the dirt, it will be a slower haul, and it may actually not be a continuant. So we're looking for continuant energy power, and so that would be a use of the tanks. Now, of course, the fight is why we have the tanks at all. Why have the tanks at all? If we're like, isn't that the wrong thing? But I don't know. It's an energy obligation choice, especially now in this time frame. Now, if China or any country in this particular world goes and says no, we want to keep the money printing on our particular soil, and yet absolutely adopt what the rest of the world is doing with this economy, this economic revolution. So with this economic revolution, they are of course jazzed in their eyes. I have to take it, and yet they do not want to part with their printing machines. So the printing machines of their currency, which is understandable. Now, if they want to participate on their own and do it on their own country scale. Donate the 20,000 each to the persons, and then there you are with yet again, the gauntlet down. I know, the 20,000 each to the persons, and then there you are with your own printer, and there you are with your own currency, and there you are with your own collection from your own property world, from that acquisitions, the acquisitions each time they buy, each time they sell, that the government receives the 25%. So this is the wonder of it, and that is the only taxation that keeps the system. So as they are doing this, again and again and again, they say, okay, my particular, I stay, and I'm not joining with the others. So this one country that has decided this, to not join with the others, they will receive economic inflictions because of so. They're just not going to be traded with as often. Less and less will be traded with them, so they will receive less trade orders from other places in the world. So there will be I don't want to say a stop, but it will lessen, and I don't know. It just seems like a bad deal. Do it all at once. Get everyone here all at once. Do it. And if this is the problem, we have two or three that are just astounded. We're North Korea. We can never change. That is ridiculous. persons want to go to North Korea. We want to see your beautiful flowers. We hear you have wonderful gardens. We hear you have the most beautiful gardens in the world, actually. And so this is a temptation that you have tried to you know you've already created them for us to be tempted into want them. So there is peace there. You already want the peace with us that way. So don't lie. Don't lie, you definitely want it. So when I'm there now, I'm thinking, well, we have the one central bank trying, because it will be a try attempt of every currency all being printed in one location. It'll be like a currency city where they have to be printing little tiny kind of like a Disneyland, really, when you go to Small World, and they'll just be printing. Oh, this is where we print the South Africans over there, the rands, and this is over here where we're printing the bahts. This over here we're printing the rupees, and there's the ruples, and so we're having all of this, and the yens are over there. But this is only for this is when we're printing in this tiny little Disneyland Small World print scenario. We're only printing the money that has to be recycled. You know, the recycled money when it just falls apart. When you have, you know, the rips in the dollars, or this money, it's been overwashed in the laundry. This type of you know, in your washing machine, that is the money that we are trying to remake. So that is the only paper currency of the remake. Of this little tiny Disneyland currency village. Now we can go this way and have one village, or we can have several villages. Now if we do this several village version, which means not just one central bank, we'll have two or three. Obviously France is the first choice, because France has never ever in recent times began a war. France has not started a war. So they have followed into, but they have not started. So they are accoladed in central bank allocation allow. Now other countries in the world that have not started a war recently are allowed to have a central bank. That is the rules. That is the rules of fair. Now the ones who have started wars recently are not allowed. They're no longer allowed to. That's just the way it goes. Just go the way it goes. It's a bully, you know, too much a bully. So so who else wants? Because my gosh, maybe France is tired of Disneyland villages. I was thinking Estonia, actually. I was thinking Estonia was a good place to have a little you know, because what is there? There is the beautiful, there's the Swedish krona, there is also, there is the British pound. The Estonia can take care of the British pound, the Swedish krona, and I believe the Norwegian kron or something, I don't know, or something of this status. And who is going to be printing Greenland, my goodness? Greenland is, I'm not even sure the currency of Greenland. Maybe how many deers you have in your house or in your garden, maybe they're still on that type of currency, which is interesting. If they are into the reindeer currencies still. Yeah, those are my favorite type of collections of how government is capacitating itself, you know, because they are a government right there. That the little tribe, you know, this little tribe trading to another little tribe, you know, that's the beginning. It's the beginning of how it is all done, and that peace acquisition at that moment before the big heavies of my gosh, now I have to turn the Tiananmen into a perpetual motion of energy that stops all the pollution in Beijing, you know what I'm saying? And so there it goes, and well, there it's done, and so it's exciting. It's an exciting time, isn't it? Exciting time for the world, a very exciting time. I think in all of the excitement, we still have to keep our heads straight on where we are going, and not make silly businesses too silly. We will be tempted to turn many of the machines of war into ridiculous rides at Disneyland and turn them into the Dumbo rides and these types of things, you know, for the children to get into. Is it necessary? Is that necessary? I preferred other things, perhaps, like take them and melt them down and turn them into some kind of, like I was saying, the little Hot Wheels, the little Hot Wheel cars. You know, those, they used to be all metal. They used to be all metal. And at one point they changed them. And that was when they were really good. And we prefer the little metal cars with the little tires, specific. That was the better vehicles, and I think that is, it disrupted the little children. And receiving the plastic gift child toys. I don't believe those have been great. I mean, did you have the metal, the little tiny metal ones? Or did you have a little plastic car? You know, it's a very different thought in a man's brain, isn't it? I think so. So anyway, that is enough. That's enough. That's where I stop today. I have to let that out there. The Tiananmen energy pollution stopping device. Stopping the pollution, because of that energy, that beautiful energy that it keeps recreating in a dynamo fashion. Very, very, very cool. So that is a new work for everyone, is to get those winders into the turbines, then from there becomes this constant source. All right.